Here's a claim. The limit of 2x as x approaches 10 is 20. And to justify this claim using an epsilon delta argument, I have to be able to produce a delta for every epsilon. Right? You're going to demand that 2x be within epsilon of 20. I'm going to satisfy your demand by saying x is within some number delta of 10. So proof, let epsilon be bigger than 0. I don't know how small a number epsilon you're going to choose. I'm going to set delta equal to epsilon over 2. I'm going to check now that this value of delta will work to satisfy your demand involving epsilon. So if 0 is less than x minus 10 is less than delta, right? If x is within delta of 10, then if you multiply by 2, we see that 2 times x minus 10 is less than 2 delta. But what's 2 delta? Delta is epsilon over 2. 2 delta is just epsilon. So then 2 times the absolute value of x minus 10 is less than 2 delta, which is epsilon. And so 2 times the absolute value of x minus 10, that's the absolute value of 2x minus 20. And that's less than epsilon. So look at what we've shown, right? Some epsilon bigger than 0, a corresponding value of delta is going to be epsilon over 2. And then I verify that if x is within 10, is within delta of 10, then 2x is within epsilon of 20. And that's exactly what it means to say that the limit of 2x is 20 as x approaches 10. For every epsilon, there's some delta, so that whenever x is within delta of 10, then the function 2x is within epsilon of 20. And you can imagine trying to do this with other functions, right? But I'll let you try that. You can try that in the exercise included below.